So next connection of capacitors is what we call parallel connection. Okay, suppose these are the three capacitors connected in parallel. So how are these capacitors, how are this connection differ from the series connection? Alright, so in series connection, if this is positively charged plate of this capacitor and this is the negatively charged of this capacitor, then this is the positively charged plate of capacitor 2 and this is the negatively charged plate of the capacitor 2, and that is the positive plate of the capacitor 3, and this is the plate of negative plate of capacitor 3. As looking at this circuit diagram where these three capacitors are connected in series, the negative plate of capacitor 1 is connected directly to the positive plate of C2, and then the negative plate of C2 is connected directly to the positive plate of C3. Alright, while in parallel, what's the difference between parallel? So before I'll connect that to voltage source, okay? So these three capacitors are connected in parallel. So the plates of the parallel are, the plates of the capacitors that are connected in parallel are initially neutral. So the charge here is zero. The charge is zero. So the number of protons will be the number of electrons for this plate. The number of electrons and protons are equal for this plate. So these three, these six plates are neutral. And then suppose that the capacitance of capacitor 3 is greater than the capacitance of capacitor 2, and capacitor 2 has a greater capacitance compared to capacitor 1. Right. So from the equation where capacitance is obtained, capacitance is charge over voltage, right? So since capacitance is directly proportional to the voltage, so it means this capacitance must have greater charge compared to C2 compared to C1, right? Then the lower the capacitance, the lower the charge of that capacitor. So it means C1 has the lowest charge. Alright, by looking at the, and then I will connect these three capacitors in a voltage source, right? Then electrons will start to flow from this terminal, from this plate, right? And then going back to that plate. So since this capacitor 3 has greater capacitance compared to these three capacitors, then it will release more charge. Let's say 3 electrons is released, and then C2 is greater than C1, or capacitance 2 is greater than capacitance 1, so capacitor 2 will release more electrons compared to C1. Okay, so let's say capacitor 1 will release 1 electron. Okay, and again, these three capacitors are connected already to the voltage source V. So when you connect that, then electrons will flow. Now, since C1 has the least capacitance, then it will gain, this plate of capacitor 1 will gain the least number of electrons. And then next is this capacitor, the plate of this capacitor will have a electron lesser compared to the electrons that will receive by this plate of capacitor 3, since capacitor 3 is greater than capacitor 2 and capacitor 1. Okay, so let's go back to the capacitors that are connected in series. Okay, the negative plate of C1 is connected to the positive plate of C2, but here for parallel, the negative plate of C2 is connected directly to the negative plate of C1, and then this negative plate of C3 is connected directly to the negative plate of C2. Okay, and all these capacitors are connected directly to the voltage source. Unlike in unlike in series connection, right, the negative plate of this capacitor is not connected directly to the voltage source. Okay, so it will pass through first C2 and then pass to C3 before it is connected to the voltage. Okay, so this is the parallel connection. The positive plate of the, since there are three electrons for this plate of capacitor 3, then this plate must have three protons, exists of three protons. So the positive plate of capacitor 3 is connected directly to the positive plate of capacitor 2. Since there are two electrons at this plate, then this plate will have two protons because it loses two electrons, and then this plate will have one proton since this is a positively charged plate. Now the positively charged plate of C2 is connected directly to the positively charged plate of C1, and all positively charged plate are connected directly to the positive terminal of the voltage. So unlike in series connection, the positive terminal of C1 is connected directly to the positive terminal of voltage, or the positive plate of C1 is connected directly to the positive terminal of the voltage. But the positive plate of C2, it's not connected directly to the positive terminal of the voltage, but it should pass through first to the plate of negative plate of C1 and then negative positive plate of C2. So that's the difference between parallel connection and series connection. All right. So what is the voltage across each capacitor? All right. Now, since all plates of these three capacitors are connected directly to the voltage, unlike in series connection, then these three capacitors will have equal voltage across each plate. So V1 is the voltage, V3 is the voltage across C3, V2 is the voltage across C2, and V1 is the voltage across C1. Alright, now since again the plates are connected directly to the voltage source, so each capacitor will experience equal amount of voltage difference. So it's constant, right? Constant. So as the increase of more capacitance, greater charge. Okay, lower capacitance, lower capacity charge, since these two quantities are directly proportional. So in parallel connection, the total voltage will be the voltage equal to the voltage experienced at C1, and which is also equal to the voltage experienced in C2, which is also equal to the voltage experienced by C3, or that's V3. Right, but what is the equivalent capacitance of this circuit if capacitors are connected in parallel? Alright, so since capacitance is charge per voltage, or voltage is charge per capacitance, okay, or capacitance is charge is capacitance times voltage. Okay, so what's the total charge? The total charge is the sum of all charges. Since there are three capacitors, then we have Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Alright, so remember this, that Q equals the charge equals the capacitance times the voltage. And then Q1 is the capacitance of capacitor 1 times the voltage across capacitor 1, and then Q2 as the charge of capacitor 2 will be the capacitance of capacitor 2, which is C2 times the voltage across capacitor 2, which is V2. Okay, and Q3 is the capacitance of capacitor 3 times the voltage across capacitor 3. Okay, since the total charge is the sum of all charges, then Q1 is C1, P1, C2 is Q2 is C2, V2, and then Q3 is C3, V3, and then this Q is CV, the equivalent capacitance times the total voltage. So since all voltages across or all voltage differences across each capacitor are equal, then you can cancel this. Then the equivalent capacitance is C1 plus C2 plus C3. So this is the equivalent capacitance, the sum of all capacitance for each capacitor. In parallel connection, the potential difference for all individual capacitors is the same and is equal to the voltage. So suppose this is the circuit diagram and there is voltage across AB. So the voltage between AB is equal to the voltage of the capacitor 1, which is also equal to the voltage across capacitor 2. Now since V1 equals Q1 over C1 and V2 equals Q2 over C2, or Q1 equals C1 times B, then this one, Q over V, is the equivalent capacitance, then that will be equal to C1 plus C2. So the charges, okay, the charges on the individual capacitors add to give the total charge on the parallel combination. So suppose we have nth number of capacitors. There are nth capacitors. So the total charge will be the charge at charge of C1, the charge at capacitor 2, plus the charge of capacitor 3, plus the charge of the nth capacitor. And the potential difference for all individual capacitors is the same. So the voltage across AB is equal to the voltage across 1, which is also equal to the voltage across 2, and also equal to the voltage across 3, which is also equal to the voltage across the nth capacitor. And the equivalent capacitance here for parallel combination of capacitors is the capacitance of 1, capacitor 1, plus the capacitance 2, plus the capacitance 3, plus the capacitance up to nth capacitor. Okay, so this is the equivalent capacitance when capacitors are connected in parallel. Let us have an example of capacitors that are connected in parallel. So there are 3 capacitors here. So the capacitance of capacitor 1 is 4 microfarad. The capacitance of capacitor 2 is 2 microfarad. And the capacitance of capacitor 3 is 8 microfarad. And then the total voltage for the circuit is 36 volts. And then we need to look for the voltage across each capacitors. And then the charge for each capacitor, and the total charge of the circuit, and the equivalent capacitance. So since those capacitors are connected in parallel, then the sum of the equivalent capacitance must be equal to the sum of each individual capacitance. Right, now, C1, there are 3 capacitors here. 3 capacitors connected in parallel. So C1 is 4 microfarad plus C2 is 2 microfarad plus C3, that's 8 microfarad, right? So the equivalent capacitance must be equal to 14 microfarad. All right, now how about, see, this is the equivalent capacitance, 14 microfarad. Now, how about the voltage across each capacitor, right? Now, since this three capacitors are connected in parallel, then it has these three capacitors have a total voltage of 36 volts, then it means that the voltage differences on each capacitor must be equal. So since there is 36 volts as a total voltage, then V1 must be equal to 36 volts, V2 equals 36 volts, and V3 should be equal to 36 volts. Alright, next, what is the total or the charge at every capacitor? Okay, the charge at every capacitor, since capacitance is the charge per volt, then charge is capacitance times the voltage. So Q1 must be equal to the capacitance of capacitor 1 times voltage across capacitor 1. What's the capacitance of capacitor 1? We have 4 microfarads, so this is 4 times 6 to negative 6, times 10 to the power of 6 farad times the voltage across 1 is 36 volts. Right, so Q1, okay, so Q1 is 1.44 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. Okay, that's Q1. How about Q2? Q2, or the charge of capacitor 2, Q2 must be equal to the capacitance of capacitor 2 times the voltage across capacitor 2, right? So, what is C2? That's 2 microfarads, you have 2 times 10 to negative 6 farad multiplied by the voltage across capacitor 2, which is 36 volts. That is 36 volts. Then we have the charge of capacitor 2 is 7.2 times 10 to the power of negative 5 coulomb. Okay, next is the charge of capacitor 3. So this is 3, which is the capacitance of capacitor 3 times the voltage across capacitor 3. The capacitance of capacitor 3 is 8 microfarad. So that is 8 times 10, the power of negative 6 farad, okay, multiplied by 36 volts. Then we have Q3. Then Q3 is 2.88 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. So that's the charge of capacitor 3. So let us check if we have the total charge will be equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Okay. So we have the total charge. The total charge must be Q1 is 1.44 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb plus Q2 is 7.2 times 10 to negative 6 or negative 5 coulomb plus Q3 is 2.88 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. So the total charge is 5.04 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. Right? So let us see if we can still get 5.04 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb by using this equation. Okay? So the total capacity, the equivalent capacitance must be So the total charge must be the equivalent capacitance times the voltage. right? The equivalent capacitance is 14 microfarad, so that will be 14 times 10 to negative 6 farad multiplied by 36 volts, and that will be equal to 5.04 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. Okay, so this is correct. Okay, if we're going to use this equation, the equivalent capacitance times the voltage, total voltage will come up with 5.04 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb as the total voltage. You can also use this one by adding all charges per capacitor. Okay, so that is example number one. So you have example number two, where capacitors are connected in parallel, and then we're going to determine the voltage across each capacitors, and then the charge per capacitor, and we'll obtain the total charge and the equivalent capacitance. So I have here four capacitors that are connected in parallel, where capacitor 1 has a capacitance of 24 microfarad, capacitor 2 has a capacitance of 12 microfarad, and then capacitor 3 has a capacitance of 6 microfarad, and then C4 has a capacitance of 3 microfarad. Alright, so let us obtain first the equivalent capacitance of that circuit. So since capacitors are connected in parallel, then the total the equivalent capacitance here is the sum of each capacitance. So you have C1 plus C2, okay, plus C3 plus C4, since you have four capacitance. Then C1 is 24 microfarad plus C2 is 12 microfarad plus C3 is 6 microfarad, so 6 microfarad plus C4, which is 3 microfarad. Okay, then we have, what's 24 plus 12? So we have the equivalent capacitance equal to 45 microfarad. Okay, so that is the equivalent capacitance. I'll write it here. So next is to obtain the voltage across each capacitor. The total voltage, total voltage is 18 volts. So meaning, that's 18 volts. So meaning the voltage across capacitor 1 must be equal to 18 volts. The voltage across capacitor 2 must be also equal to 18 volts. Okay, and then the voltage across capacitor 3 must be also equal to 18 volts. And then the voltage across capacitor 4 must be equal to 18 volts. That's 18 volts. Next, the charge of every capacitor. So since capacitance equals charge per voltage, then charge equals capacitance times voltage, right? So Q1 must be equal to the capacitance of capacitor 1 times voltage across capacitor 1. Then next, we have C1 is 24 microfarad, and this is 24 times 10 to negative 6 farad multiplied by voltage across capacitor 1, which is 18 volts. Okay, so we have Q1 is 4.32 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. Next is Q2. The charge of capacitor 2. So next we have Q2 or charge of capacitor 2, which is the capacitance of capacitor 2 times the voltage across capacitor 2. Then we have what is the capacitance of capacitor 2? 12 microfarad, or that is 12 times 10 to negative 6 farad multiplied by voltage across capacitor 2, which is 18 volts. So this is 18 volts. And we have Q2, 2.16 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. That is the charge of capacitor 2. But the charge of capacitor 3, that is the capacitance of capacitor 3 times the voltage across capacitor 3. The capacitance of 3, 6 microfarad, then that is 6 times 10 to negative 6 farad multiplied by the voltage across capacitor 3, which is 18 volts. Okay, that's 18 volts, so you have 18 volts. Then we have Q3, it's 1.08 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. Okay, about Q4. Q4 is the capacitance of capacitor 4 times the voltage across capacitor 4. So that is capacitor 4 has the capacitance of 3 microfarad, then that is 3 times 10 to negative 6 farad times voltage across capacitor 4, which is 18 volts, and this is 18 volts. And we have 5.4 . The charge of capacitor 4 is 5.4 times 10 to negative 5. Now the total charge is the sum of all charges. So you have Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. Since there are 4 capacitors, the charge of Q1 is 4.32 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb plus the charge of capacitor 2 is 2.16 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb plus charge of 3, which is 1.08, okay, times 10 to negative 4 coulomb plus the charge of capacitor 4, then that is 5.4 times 10 to negative 5 coulomb. So we're going to add. So the total charge is 8.1 times 10 to negative 4 coulomb. Let us double check if this is really the total charge. The total charge is obtained by the equivalent capacitance and times the total voltage V. Okay, what's the total capacitance? It's 45 microfarad. Then capacitance is 45 times 10 to negative 6 farad multiplied by the voltage, total voltage, which is 18 volts. You have times 18 volts total charge. Let us check if it is still equal to 8.1 times 10 to negative 4. Alright, still equal to 8.1 times 10 to negative 4. So this is the total charge. of these four capacitors connected in parallel.